My goal is to help you make more money, so today I'm going to teach you my Vapi rag agent that's worth 10k step by step. Let's go ahead and get started. So the first thing you need to do is go up here, click import from file, click on the file name, hit open. Okay, now that you've done that, the first thing we're going to need to do is double click on Google Gemini chat model. Here we're going to need to add a new credential, unless you already have one, just select yours. So it says we're going to get an API key. So to get that API key, we're going to need to go to Google AI Studio. So now that we're here, we need to click get API key. We're going to hit create API key. Search for a project. If you don't have one, just make one real quick and then this will pop up. So hit project and then create API key. I already have one, so I'm just going to click that and hit copy. So go back over here, paste, and then hit save, and it's going to make it for you. I already have plenty, so I'm not gonna make it. Okay, so, and then this is actually the same thing, so just double click that, and it'll automatically load it. So the next thing we're gonna need to do is we're going to need to set up these Google Drive nodes. So in order to do Google Drive, double click in, we're gonna need to create a new credential. It's asking for a client ID and a client secret. So to get those, we're gonna need to go to Google Cloud Console. Now that you're in Google Cloud Console, all we need to do is search for API. Click on API and services, by the way. Then click on enable APIs and services. Now that we're here, we're going to need to search for Google Drive. So click on Google Drive API and then hit enable. All right, now we hit on credentials. And then you're going to need to create a new credential. So OAuth client ID. Application type is web application. And here it's asking for a redirect URI. And this is just going to be the URL that we have over here. So click that to copy. Go back over to Google Cloud, paste, create. Now it's going to give you your client ID and your client secret. So copy that, paste, copy the client secret, paste. Sign in with Google. So just go ahead and click your email, continue, select all, continue, connection successful. All right, so there's one more thing we need to do here. Just go over here to the left, click on audience, and we need to add ourselves as a test user. So hit add users, type in your email here, and hit save. Okay, so now we're going to go into Supabase. So click on this, we're going to need a new credential. And it's asking for our role secret. So we're going to go to supabase.com. All right, start your project. Sign up. So, all right, so now that we're in Supabase, we're going to need to get that URL and that API key. All right, so scroll down here. This is going to be your project URL. So hit copy, go back to n8n, paste. Service role secret. You will go to view API settings and hit that. API keys here on the left, service role secret, reveal, copy. Service role secret, paste, save. Okay, done, perfect. So that's done. No thanks. So that looks good. Now this is going to use the same thing, so we'll go ahead and load that up. That's fine, we'll update that later. So Google, same thing, right? Yep, that's good. This one, same thing. Yep. So next thing that we need to do is we need to create a database in Supabase. So the way that we do that is you're going to need to get the file from my school community, and it's going to be called Supabase SQL editor code. So go ahead and click on that to open that up. Now that you're in, hit Control A, Control C to copy. Go back into Supabase and then go over here on the left and click SQL Editor. New SQL snippet. You're gonna see this code editor, hit Control V to copy to paste and hit run. That's basically gonna help us create a data table that's gonna help us to put the data in. So now we're gonna go to Table Editor. And as you can see, there should be one created. It's going to be called knowledge base. So now we need to go back and select it. So here, double click on this and then choose the table. So it's going to be called knowledge base. Same thing over here, choose a table, knowledge base. Knowledge base. So actually it's saying that we need to use our function, which is called match documents. Go back over to that over here and put match documents. Over here, match documents. Now that that is done, we need to create a table. We need to create a folder for Google Drive. So we're going to go to Google Drive, and then you're going to click on New Folder. We're going to call this Documents. All right, go in there. And from here, we're going to need to put in a file. So the one that we're going to use is called Company Information. So double click on that. It's going to pop up with some information about my company. So copy. And then we're going to create a new Google Doc. Perfect. Just hit paste. And that'll create it for you. Now go back to n8n. Now we need to set our folder. It should be updated. So we hit documents. Perfect. Same thing with over here. Documents. Okay. Next thing to do is set up Vapi. So we're going to go to Vapi. Go to, we'll create the tool first. So go to Tools, Create Tool. It's going to be called Get User Documents. Okay. Here we need a server URL. So go back to n8n, double click on this one. And we're going to need the production URL. So click on that and click on that's copy. Put it in there, hit save. Now we're going to need to enter our parameters, which is what the tool needs. So click on Visual Editor here. And then we're going to find our code from over here. So double click get user documents tool.json. It's going to open it up, copy, paste, apply, save. Okay, now that's done. Go to assistance, create an assistant. We're going to name it FAQ agent. Yeah, whatever, FAQ agent, create assistant. Now that that is made, make sure you choose 4.1 mini because that's the best one. Okay, and for the system prompt, we're going to need to go back over here, click on rag agent assistant prompt.json, double click. Then we're going to get the prompts, come over here, paste. And then this one I like to just say, hello, this is Amanda. Let's see. Yeah, something like that. Yeah, this one. How may I help you today? That's good. Temperature, the best one is 0.4. That's fine. Tools, select tools. And then we're going to give it the one that we just made. So get user documents and then hit publish. Click on phone numbers. Create your phone number. So now that you have your number, you can label it whatever you want, right? You can label it rag agent. That's fine. That's going to be your number. And here, assistant, you're going to choose the agent that you just made. So that's going to be the assistant. We can actually go to our Supabase and we can see that there's no data in here right now, right? So in order to put the data in there, we need to go over here and use the one that's called file created, because we just created a document, but it's never been loaded up. So we use this one for loading up a file that was newly created, and we use this one for automatically updating files that have been updated. So we're going to go ahead and click on execute workflow over here. So now it's going to go through and successful. So it should have updated the information here. So I'm just going to refresh that. And yep, that's correct. So it created two different chunks of information. So that's perfect. So now that the workflow is active, just call the phone number.
Hello, this is Amanda from Apex Agent Systems. How may I help you today?
What is the company name?
The company name is Apex Agent Systems. Is there anything else I can help you with today?
What is the purpose?
The purpose of Apex Agent Systems is to help businesses increase revenue with custom AI voice agents and to teach students how to profit by building and selling them. Is there anything else I can help you with today?
To show you also that you can actually update it whenever you want. So this will actually automatically update it. So if we update our database, so let's say the company name is, I don't know, Ajax agent systems, okay? Then it'll actually automatically update it. So we can go to our database over here and watch that it automatically updates. And as you can see, it automatically got updated. So that's perfect. So that is it. I just showed you the step-by-step tutorial of how to build a Vapi RAG agent that automatically updates itself based on the information that you gave it in the Google document for your company information. So make sure you subscribe, because the next video that I'm going to make is going to be an even more mind-blowing AI agent. So I'll see you in the next video.